In today's video, we are going to be going over the lovely specialty of family medicine. I'm going to be going over what it's like as a resident in training, as well as give you a lot of opportunities that there are to become an attending in family medicine. Hi and welcome or welcome back to this channel. My name is Dr. Lindsay Marie. I'm a board certified family medicine physician. And on this channel, I like to share a message of hope, health, and wellness for the mind, body, and soul. I also like to speak to medical students and aspiring doctors. So if that is something you're interested in, please be sure to subscribe. And without any further ado, let's get into this topic. I'm going to be using my computer throughout part of today's video, and what I wanted to do was go over a YouTube video that is by Dr. Kevin Jabal on his YouTube channel called Med School Insiders. It is a very well-known YouTube channel that is geared toward medical students and all those who want to become a doctor. He developed a series called So You Want to Be, and he goes over various specialties. Unfortunately, he does not yet have a So You Want to Be a Family Medicine Doctor video yet, but he does have another video that briefly explains about family medicine, so I thought it would be good to watch that as a brief synopsis, and then I will give you my reaction and my take on family medicine. So here we go.
Family medicine is the specialty devoted to comprehensive medical treatment of patients across all ages. Think of them as the first-line defense when it comes to maintaining health. Family med doctors are central to routine checkups, preventative care, health risk assessments, immunization, screening tests, and acting as the coordination hub to manage the patient's big-picture treatment across several specialties. While less common, some family medicine doctors also deliver babies and provide prenatal care to pregnant women, which is now more commonly performed by OB-GYN doctors. Family medicine is a foundational specialty to medicine, with nearly one out of every four office visits being made to a family med physician. That's 208 million office visits per year, with the next closest specialty at 83 million visits. They're also the ones doing most of the heavy lifting in treating America's underserved and rural populations. After completing medical school, you must complete either a 3 or 4 year family medicine residency. If you'd like to specialize, there are multiple fellowship options to choose from, including geriatric medicine, sports medicine, sleep medicine, hospital medicine, and hospice and palliative care. In terms of lifestyle, family physicians have predictable hours without unexpected calls in the middle of the night. In terms of compensation, however, they're towards the bottom, making on average $231,000 per year.
Okay, so that was just a quick video about family medicine and a brief overview, and now I wanted to give you guys an idea of what it's like as a family medicine doctor who went through all the training myself, and give you guys some ideas and tips about residency, as well as what kind of opportunities you can expect when you become an attending in family medicine. So like Dr. Jabal mentioned in this video, family medicine is a very comprehensive scope of medicine. You are going to be seeing patients of all ages, from babies to small infants and children, all the way up into the adult years and even geriatrics. There is a lot of variety in family medicine, from procedures to primary care work to surgeries to even OBGYN, where you can deliver babies. With family medicine seeing more of a variety of cases and not necessarily one set specialty, sometimes it gets lumped under the category of general practice or general medicine. And that is true, but it is somewhat of a misnomer. I believe in other countries such as the UK, a family medicine doctor would be considered a general practitioner. However, in the United States, a general practitioner is one who has not completed a residency program, which is not the case for the family medicine doctor. The family medicine doctor does complete 4 years in medical school and then goes on to do a 3-year residency in family medicine. The residency is not specialized to one area, but afterward you can further specialize within family medicine and complete a 1-year fellowship if you would choose. If you are one who likes variety and gets bored easily with focusing on one topic, then family medicine might be a great opportunity for you because family medicine can give you an opportunity to treat many types of patients in all areas of medicine. Now, because family medicine can be considered so broad, some might say you are the jack of all trades and master of none, like the old saying goes, but it really all depends on what you want to focus on and what you want to specialize in even after family medicine. So now I would like to go over what it's like to go through a family medicine residency training program, and this will give you an idea of the various types of requirements as well as the rotations you go through, what you can expect as far as the types of patients you'll be seeing, what types of procedures you get to do, and so on. So I'm just going to use my computer again for this part. I have a sample curriculum from my residency program that I went through, and I just wanted to go over it with you guys so you can kind of see what types of rotations you can expect throughout a family medicine residency. So I went to a family medicine residency program in Daytona Beach, Florida, by the name of Halifax Health. It was a beautiful hospital, really big actually. It had 900 inpatient beds and one of the largest ERs in all of Florida. And that's something that you want to consider if you are considering applying to residencies in family medicine. You want to look to see what the size of the hospital is and what types of patient volume they get into their hospital so that you can know what type of training you will receive at that program. Another thing to consider is how many babies are born each day there or each month, and to see if you would get an adequate training for OBGYN. So this was our sample curriculum, and this is their newest one, looks like. What I liked about my program is that we did have 3-week rotations, whereas a lot of programs have 4-week rotations. There's advantages and disadvantages to both of those. I liked the 3 weeks because I felt like it was just enough to learn and get into the momentum of that rotation, but not get burnt out by the 4th week. But they do split it up into various categories, and these you will see are going to be very similar to the rotations that you had throughout medical school. There is a very large focus on medicine. So medicine is going to be your internal medicine program, and it's going to be seeing patients in the hospital. You will be on a team of other doctors who work in internal medicine or as hospitalists in the hospital, and you will be responsible for taking care of all of the inpatients. Each residency program usually has a cap on the amount of inpatients that you will see per day. And for us, that cap was 15 for one team. However, we did have 2 medicine teams and 1 peds team, which we were responsible for as a resident overnight on call. So medicine is one of the heavier rotations in the family medicine residency program. It's the one where you're going to be working most of your hours, usually up to 80 hours a week that you will be spending at the hospital taking care of very sick patients. A lot of the types of patients that you would see in the hospital include people who have suffered strokes or heart attacks, people who have very serious infections that you are monitoring on IV antibiotics until they get better, people who have recently completed a surgery and they are still in the hospital for monitoring. We saw a lot of people with substance abuse and drug addictions working through their infections or chronic diseases due to their habits. We also saw a lot of very critically ill patients who just have a lot of chronic diseases that you're managing all at once. You do have the opportunity to consult various specialists within the hospital to help you manage these patients while you are taking care of them. Being on an internal medicine rotation as a family medicine doctor really develops your skills in hospital work and hospital medicine so that afterward, if you choose, you can become a hospitalist. This also builds your foundation of your knowledge of diseases and managing diseases based on lab values and medications, and you really develop your skills in your bedside manner, rounding on patients every morning to see how they are doing and if they are getting better from the diseases that are bringing them into the hospital. I have a lot of good memories from my internal medicine rotations in family medicine residency, but it was also some of the most challenging parts of residency. So it's just going to be a time where you will see what it's really like to be a doctor. Okay, so the next rotation they have listed here is OB, and in your first year of residency, it looks like they require at least 6 weeks of training in OBGYN. In family medicine, there is a set number of deliveries that you will have to complete before you are allowed to graduate in family medicine. So when I was going through training, that number for me was 40 deliveries. We had to have 40 completed deliveries on our own as a resident, and we also had to have 10 continuity deliveries, which just means we had to see our patient at least 2 times before delivery, deliver their baby, and see them 1 time for their postpartum visit. Now, 10 doesn't sound like that many throughout the span of the 3 years, but given your busy schedule in residency and maybe missing a delivery here and there from being off on vacation or just having another responsibility in your residency, it was a little bit difficult to get all of those 10 just in time for graduation. You really had to work at managing your schedule and being there for your continuity delivery whenever they delivered. But that just makes it all the more interesting. If you are a medical student and considering OBGYN, but you're not sure if you want to take on all the responsibilities that an OBGYN doctor has, and you would still love to have the opportunity to deliver babies, you can have that opportunity in family medicine, even if it's during your residency training and you choose not to continue it afterward. It's still a really great time to experience that, and I also have some very good memories from my time in OBGYN in residency. The next rotation listed here is pediatrics, and this is also considered a heavy rotation, meaning you will spend more hours at the hospital. We do both inpatient and outpatient pediatrics. What I would say about pediatrics is that it is very technical, and it is very important that you are good at math and that you pay attention to details. Because for children, especially in the inpatient setting, you are going to be giving them medications that are calculated based on their body weight. And any calculation that is even just slightly off can dramatically affect the patient and the health of the patient. So that was probably the most stressful part of going through pediatrics in family medicine residency. I also had the opportunity to see many, many very sick pediatric patients, which was very heartbreaking and hard to go through. And as a new doctor, new to family medicine, new to treating pediatric patients, it can be very nerve-wracking when the health of a child who is in very critical condition is in your hands. So as a family medicine resident, it's very important that you choose a program that has a lot of support in the pediatric department so that when cases like this arise, you can have help and someone to go to. So the next rotation is surgery. And by the way, they don't have this exact schedule. They do break up these rotations throughout the year so that you can have a variety and not go through all of this at once. And surgery, again, I would say if you love surgery but you're not sure you want to be a surgeon, you still get tons more surgery experience in family medicine residency, and you can be first assist. Depending on the surgeons you work with, you can build really good relationships with them, and they can give you a lot of autonomy in these surgery rotations, and you would be surprised at what you can do in surgery even in a family medicine residency. I am one who loves surgery and being in the OR, but I knew I was not cut out to be a surgeon, so this was actually a fun time for me. I loved and enjoyed all of my surgery rotations. So these first rotations that we talked about were more of the heavy rotations and the ones where you're going to be spending a lot more time. These other rotations for us were considered lighter rotations, meaning we didn't have to spend as much time at the hospital. And it's also during these times when they schedule more of your clinic. So in family medicine, in addition to all of your hospital work and all of your rotations, they do schedule you for your own outpatient clinic at least 1 to 2 times per week. At least that's for your first year. They increase that amount as you go along. But that's when you are in your outpatient clinic. You're seeing a panel of patients, which in residency was about 1,000 patients. When you become an attending, the average patient panel that you will have for an outpatient setting is going to be around 2,000 patients. So in clinic is the time that you get a chance to build patient relationships, and that's what family medicine is all about. It's all about continuity of care, building relationships with your patients, and just having a time where you can influence a patient to improve their health, especially in the areas of chronic disease, including diabetes, high blood pressure, high cholesterol. There are also times where you will see patients are not so compliant with your treatment options, and then you will see the side effects and the negative effects from that. For instance, there was a couple of patients that I had that no matter what I did to manage their diabetes or high blood pressure, they just did not want to follow the treatment guidelines, and unfortunately, they did end up with a stroke. And that's something I had to work through with them and even see them in the hospital when they were being treated for their stroke. So it's just very interesting the types of patients that you will get. Some will just love you and do everything that you say, while others are still considered more of the complicated patient. And you have to find ways to help work with them and treat them the best you can. But back to these electives, they do have electives in radiology, they have outpatient pediatrics, cardiology, ER. ER is very good training for any family medicine doctor because on the inpatient side, like I said, you're going to be admitting patients from the ER all night long and then seeing them the next day. So it's good to see the front end of admitting a patient from the ER and seeing them all the way through their care in the hospital until they are discharged from the hospital. And electives, you can choose whatever you want. I chose dermatology. I also chose urology. There's other specialties that if you are interested in those, you can choose those as your elective. So that wraps up the first year of family medicine residency. I will say there are specific challenges with each year of residency. The first year's challenge is that you are brand new to being a doctor and you have no idea what you're doing the first day you get in the hospital, but along the way through trial and error, through nurses helping you, through other co-residents helping you, you grow and learn how to become a doctor pretty quickly. Also, after your first year of residency training, and I believe it is like this for other residencies as well, but you will be taking your USMLE Step 3 exam. And once you complete that exam, it depends on the residency that you go to, but some will allow you to start moonlighting after that, which means you can make more money. I chose not to moonlight during my residency because it was just enough to get through my residency program. I couldn't be bothered by an extra load of work on top of that. But if you are an overachiever and want more money to pay off your loans, then that is something that you can look forward to. In second year of residency, I would say the main challenge is the call schedule, at least for my program. That is when we stepped it up a notch and we had 30-hour call in the hospital overnight every fourth night. So that is something that you really have to get used to. Your whole body has to get used to a new sleeping schedule. Cramming in a 30-hour call, which can be very stressful and very hectic, by the way, in the hospital each night, any number of things can happen as a family medicine resident. I would be called for a code blue, having to go manage the code blue, giving directions to all the nurses. Sometimes we did have the hospitalist there helping us, but at times we were the ones in charge. Then from the code blue, I would be running immediately to go deliver a baby. After I delivered a baby, I would run down to the ER to admit more patients overnight. And at times, certain patients would be crashing in the night. I would run upstairs to another floor to help take care of a patient who was not doing well. And all of those things added up to be a very stressful time in residency. But again, as a doctor, that's just one of the things you're gonna have to look forward to. Your adrenaline starts pumping and you just go into action and take care of what needs to be taken care of. In our second year of residency, it looks like we had a few more elective opportunities. We also had something called practice management. This rotation just gives you more training in the business side of things and how things run in an outpatient setting behind the scenes. You will learn more about billing and coding and how doctors get paid through insurance reimbursements and things like that. And then community medicine, I really liked this one as well. This is where we got to visit a school for the deaf and the blind. We got to see a school specifically for disabled children. And we got to visit the Salvation Army, which is an organization for homeless people. And we got to see the behind the scenes there and what type of medical needs they have. And we also got to work at a clinic that were geared for the underserved or patients who do not have insurances or a way to pay for their healthcare. So if you are one who has a heart for the underserved or the homeless population, community medicine is involved within family medicine, and it is a great opportunity for anyone who has that passion as well. And that brings us to the third year of medicine. As you can see, you have a lot more electives, at least in my program we did. And we also had something called acutes clinic. This is gonna be more like an urgent care setting. And this is something I wasn't expecting that I would go into, but it turns out after I graduated from my residency program, I chose to work in urgent care as my first job. And this acutes clinic really set me up well for that. As a family medicine doctor, you're used to seeing patients with a lot of chronic illnesses, like we talked about, diabetes, high blood pressure, high cholesterol, and you're constantly managing those and treating those types of patients. But in an acutes clinic or an urgent care setting, patients are coming in for one complaint. Usually they have sore throat or they have fallen onto their wrist and possibly broken or sprained their wrist. They have other conditions like a rash that they are concerned about. So with the acutes clinic or an urgent care setting, you can expect to just see one main complaint, you can help treat it, and then they can get better more quickly. And you may or may not see the same patient back, so you'll have a variety of new patients every day. Whereas in the family practice setting, you will be seeing your patients on a weekly or yearly basis and treating their chronic conditions. One other elective that I didn't get to mention for family medicine is the sports medicine elective and later on fellowship. Sports medicine can be very exciting for the person who loves sports and also healthcare. With this rotation in residency, we got to see the treatment and management of many joint injuries. We also had the opportunity to work at the local college's football team and being their designated physician for any sports injuries, which was a lot of fun. So that's something to also consider as an opportunity in family medicine. So I think that wraps up the general discussion that I wanted to go over today as far as all of the various rotations you can expect in a family medicine residency. Now, each program is going to have slight differences depending on the program, but that's something you can look into on their website and see what type of curriculum that they offer. I also just wanted to give you guys a brief summary on some of the fellowships that you can do after family medicine. So like we just talked about, sports medicine is one. The other ones include geriatric medicine, where you can work as a medical director of a nursing home if you choose. Another one is called integrative medicine, and this is something that I actually considered going into after I graduated, but when it came down to it, I just decided I don't want to do any more training, I'm done. So I didn't go into it, but I still look up the topics in integrative medicine and study them on my own because it's something I'm very interested in. And it is basically focused on nutrition and preventative medicine, as well as some other alternative medicines, including Indian or Chinese type medicine and other Eastern medicines that you have not learned about over here in the Western world. I believe they also have a fellowship in addiction medicine and pain management, if that's something you're interested in. And lastly, they have a further fellowship in OB training if you are considering to be a family medicine doctor who goes on to do OB in your practice. Most of these fellowships are 1 year, I believe, and they add extra training for you as you go on to become a family medicine attending. All right, so I hope that that overview on some of the rotations that you can expect in a family medicine residency gave you a lot of idea of what it's like to be in family medicine, at least as a resident. Until next time, bye!